हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य। और इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल्स इन एक्सरसाइज 13। बिफोर दैट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इन्फॉर्मेशन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कैलेंडर। इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन द कैलेंडर। So before that, we will learn some facts about the calendar. You know, calendar is related with the year. Understood? So see, in 1 year, how many months are there? You know, 1 year means how many months? Or a year is made up of how many months? 12 months, correct? 12 months. Understood? Again, 1 year means how many days? 365 days in normal year and 366 days in leap year. Okay? Normal year, regular year. So in 1 year, there are 365 days in normal year and 366 days in leap year. You know leap year means what? Leap year is the year which comes after every 4 years, okay? Or every fourth year. Every fourth year is the leap year. Okay? And how to identify leap year? It is divisible by 4. If you divide that year, for example, this year 2020, it is leap year. It is divisible by 4. If you divide this, 4 or 5 is 20, 0, 0, 2 came down, 2 0, 4 zeros are 0, 2 came down, 2 minus 0, 2, 20, 4, 5 is 20, okay? So, this year, 2020 is divisible by 4. That means it is a leap year, okay? So, every 4th year is leap year. Now, this 2020 is leap year. Next leap year will be 2024, then 2028, 2032, 2036, 2040, in this way. So every fourth year is the leap year. And you know, in normal year, February month has how many days? 28 days, correct? February has 28 days. Whereas in leap year, February month has 29 days. That this one day extra is there, no? That is added in the month of February. It has 29 days. Understood? So, the February month having 29 days comes after every fourth year. Understood? Now see, these are the days. 12 months, year is made up of 12 months, January, February, March, in this way, you know that till December. First month is January, last month is December. Now, here, to solve the questions based on the calendar, you must know the days in year, months, you know that. You must know the days in every month. You must know the days in every month. You know, January has how many days? 31 days, and this is the trick of keeping in mind how to memorize the days. This is the trick, you know that this is January, that means it is 31 days, then February 28 or 29, March 31, April 30, May 31, June 30, July 31, again here August is also up, so it is 31, then September 30, October 31, November 30 and December 31, again January here. 31, okay? So, this is the trick of memorizing the days in 1 year, okay? After that, see, I have a calendar of this year. I have a calendar of this year, it's 2020, not 2021. This is the last month of 2020 is going on, that is December, and after this month, new year will be started, 2021, okay? Now see, this is the calendar of 2020 month January, okay? It is given in Marathi. How many days are there in month of January? 31 days. There are 31 days. If you see this February month, there are 29 days because this is leap year. 2020 is the leap year, so there are 29 days. Otherwise, in other normal years, there will be 28 days in the month of February. Okay, in this way, the days are there. Now, the question will be asked, see, in this way. If 2020 is started on which day? This year means, here who means Budhwar means it is Wednesday, okay? It is started on Wednesday. Our first January has which day? Wednesday. First January 2020 has Wednesday. Then on 1st January 2021, which day will be there? In this way the question will be asked. Okay? So I'll tell you the trick. See, I'll talk about first normal year. First I will talk about normal year and then about leap year. So suppose 2018 is the normal year and 1st January 2018. 1st January 2018 has which day? Monday. Which day? Monday. Suppose 1st January 2018 means first day of the year 2018 started on which day? Monday. Then after exactly after 1 year, 1st January 2019, which day will be there? Within a fraction of second you can tell the answer. Not need to see the calendar. On 1st January 2018 there is Monday. Then on 1st January 2019, which day will be there? Add one day we have to add in this. Means now this is Monday. The next year will be started on next day, that is Tuesday. So on 1st January 2019 there will be Tuesday. Okay, 1st January 2018 there was Monday, and then so on the next day, next year, in the next year, on the 1st January 2019 there will be Tuesday. There will be Tuesday. Then 1st January 2020, which day will be there? 1st January 2020, again next, one day extra, that is Wednesday. Okay, then 1st January 2021, which day will be there? 1st January 2021, which day will be there? 1st January 2018 Monday, 1st January 2019 Tuesday, 1st January 2020 Wednesday. Then on 1st January 2021, which day will be there? Thursday? No, there will be no Thursday. Which day will be there? Friday. Why Friday? Why Friday? Why 2 days extra? Here if you see the pattern here, 1 day extra is there. Means here Monday, then Tuesday, next year start with Wednesday. Then why here directly Friday? Why not Thursday? Because see, this 2020, it is leap year, and in this year there is one extra day. In this year, in these 2 years, there were 365 days. But in this year there are 366 days. So normally the next year comes after 1 day, right? Next year comes on the first January of every next year, the 1 day is extra, or next day, right? For example, here Monday is there, the next year start on Tuesday. But if the year is leap year, the next year start after 2 days. Understood? So First January 2020 has Wednesday. So first January 2021 will have Friday, not Thursday, because 2020 is leap year. It has 366 days. So two days extra. Next year will start after 2 days extra. 2 days of the 1st January 2020. Okay. So 1st January 2021 will start on Friday. Okay. This is one of the trick you have to keep it in mind. After that, see here. Observe this calendar. See on 5th January. Which day is there? Sunday. So next. On 5th January there was Sunday. Then next Sunday will come on which date? Here it is given 12. But how to find if first Sunday is on 5th January, then second Sunday will come on which date? Then second Sunday will come on which date? How to find? It is very easy trick. What we have to do? First Sunday is on 5th January. To find second date of second Sunday, add 7. So 7 plus 5, 12. Third Sunday, again add 7 in this. So 12 plus 7, 19. Fourth Sunday, again add 7 in this, you will get 26. So on these days, 5, 12, 19, 26, on these 4 days there are Sundays. See here, 5, 12, 19 and 26. Okay, so why to add 7? Why to add 7? Because you know 1 week has 7 days. 1 week has 7 days. So every day repeat after 7 days. Understood? Every day repeat. Now suppose today is Saturday, and what is date today? 5. Okay, then next Saturday will come on 5 plus 7, that is 12. 12th December, next Saturday will come on 12th December. See here, today is 5, the next Saturday will come on this 12th. So to find next day we have to add 7. Understood? So these are some tricks. We will get how some problems we have to solve which are based on this calendar. We will learn with that question also. This is some basic information I have told you. Now see the questions. See the question. Question number 20. 5th January fell on Friday. Question number 20. 5th January. Which day is there? Friday. 5th January, there is Friday. What date of that month was on 2nd Thursday? What you have to find? What we have to find? Date on 2nd Thursday. Second Thursday we have to find. On first Friday, on Friday there is 5th January. Okay, you know Thursday comes before Friday. So on 5th January there was Friday. Then on 4th January there should be Thursday. 4th January. Then this will be the first Thursday. Why you know? This will be the first Thursday of that month. This is not 2nd Thursday. 4th January there will be first Thursday. First Thursday. Okay. Then on 2nd Thursday. So 2nd Thursday will be How to find second Thursday? Add 7 in the 4. 4 plus 7, that is 11th January. So second Thursday will be on 11th January. See, we had to find the date on second Thursday of that month of January. We have given date of Friday, that is 5th January. Okay, but we want Thursday. So what we have done? We found first Thursday, that is before Friday. There is Thursday, so it was on 4th January, and it is the first Thursday of the month. And to find second Thursday, we added 7 in the 4. Okay, because next Thursday will come after 7 days. So 4 plus 7, 11. So the second Thursday will be on 11th January. Understood? See next. I went to bed when the hour hand was between 1 and 2 and the minute hand pointed towards 9. So see, this question is based on clock. Let's draw clock. Four, five, 7 here, 8, 10 and 11. Now see, I went to bed when our hand, you know, our hand is short hand, it was between 1 and 2. Here somewhere, between 1 and 2, and the minute hand was pointed towards 9. Means what is time? What is this time? Our hand is after 1, means between 1 and 2, and minute hand is pointed towards 9. What is this time? I went to bed. At what time? Our hand is after 1, so 1 hour, and minute hand is at 9. That means how many minutes? 9 fives are 45. 45 minutes. Okay, that is 1 hour 45. 1.45 hour, okay? And when I got up, that means I woke up after a short nap, short sleep, the minute hand pointed towards 9. So when I woke up, the minute hand was pointed towards 4. Means here, minute hand was here. And our hand was between 2 and 3. Our hand was between 2 and 3. Okay. Now what is time here? Our hand is after 2, that means 2 hour, and minute hand is at 4. Minute hand is at 4 means how many minutes? 4 5s are 20 minutes, right? 20. Understood? So 1 45 and 2 20. This is at this time I went to bed, at this time I woke up. How much time did I take rest? That means you have to find the gap between this. Sleeping time and waking time. Okay, that means you have to find difference. So how to find difference? You know, we have to subtract sleeping time from the waking time. From the this we will subtract this. Okay, see here. Hours, minutes, two columns we will do. From this we will subtract this. Understood? Because this is greater. 2 hours 20 minutes and 1 hour 45 minutes. Now you know how to do the addition and subtraction of time. You know how to do the addition and subtraction of time? Pay attention carefully. First we have to see the minute column. In minute column there are 20 minutes, and from 20 minutes you have to subtract 45 minutes. Is it possible to subtract 45 minutes from 20 minutes? No. Okay. So we have to take borrow from our column. So see, there are 2 hours. From these 2 hours, when we will take 1 hour borrow in minute column. Now when hour will travel to minute, hour will come in minute column, it will change into minute. You know, 1 hour is how many minutes? 60 minutes. Okay, so when from these 2 hours, when 1 hour will come in the minute column, it will change into minute. That means it will change into 60, because 1 hour means 60 minutes. Understood? So this 60 minutes which we have taken borrow from R column, and this 20 minutes we will add. So now there are 80 minutes. Okay, now from this 80 minutes we will subtract 45. After taking 1 hour borrow here from this 2 hour, 1 hour we have taken borrow. So here how many hours remain? 1. Okay, now from this 80 minutes we will subtract 45. 0 minus 5 not possible. Here, sorry, 10, and here 7. Now 10 minus 5 is 5, 7 minus 4 is 3, and 1 minus 1 in R column, 1 minus 1, 0. So 0 are 35 minutes. That means only 35 minutes. So I took rest for 35 minutes. Only 35 minutes. Understood? That means you can find this orally also. 145 to 220. 145. 45 is here, and here 20 minutes means here. So this minute hand travel here 5, 10, 20, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Okay? So in this way also you can find orally. If it is MCQ, you can find orally. Understood? Next. Example number 22. How many seconds make a full day? How many seconds make a full day? Means one full day. Means one day. One day means how many hours? One day means how many hours? 24 hours. Correct? We have to find that how many seconds make full day, means in one full day, that is in 24 hours, how many seconds are there? So see, first there is day. We have to convert into second, correct? But between day and second, there are two stops, two stations. Which two stations? After day, there is hour station, and there is minute station, and then there our destination second, correct? So while converting days to seconds, we have to think about these two stations. You know, when one day means how many hours? 24 hours. 1 hour means how many minutes? 60 minutes. And 1 minute means how many seconds? 60 seconds. So one day is equal to 1 multiplied by 24 multiplied by 60 multiplied by 60. Understood? Let's multiply 60 into 60. 24 ones are 24. 60 into 60. These two zeros will be written here. 6 are 36. And 3600 multiplied by 24. 24 zeros are 0. 24 zeros are 0. 24 6s are 144, correct? 14 carry. 24 3s are 72. 72 plus 14. 82 and 4, 86. 86,400 second. One day is equal to 86,400 second. If there would be 2 days or two days, then here instead of 1 we would have taken 2. Okay? Here there is only 1 day, so just directly we have multiplied by 24 into 60 into 60. If they would have asked if 1 day means how many minutes, mean till here, then 1 multiplied by 24 multiplied by 60. Okay? Now they have asked in second, so we have taken 1 minute means 60 seconds, we know. So again we have taken 60 here. Okay? Pause this video. Next also we will see question number 23. Now see, this is very easy question based on the calendar. Sanjeev was born on 15th August 1988. Sanjeev was born on 15th August 1988 in this year. 1988. Now which year is going on? 2020. This is 1988. 1988. Okay, so he was born on 15th August 1988. Today is the 15th November. Means this is for example they have given. Today, which date is there? 15th November 1993. This was 88, this is 93. Okay. What was Sanjeev's age today in years and months? So, if he was born on 15th August 1988 and today is 15th November 1993, what was Sanjeev's age today? Or what is Sanjeev's age today in years and months? That we have to find. Okay. Years means, age means how many years he has completed. Years and months he has completed. Okay. So see the he born on 15th August 1988. Okay, so this is 93. So we will count days in every year. So this is his birthday. Okay. Now when he will complete 1 year? When he will complete 1 year? Exactly after next birthday. On next birthday, 15th August 19, after 88, 89. Okay, again next 15th August 1990, then 15th August 1991, 15th August 1992, 15th August 1992, here 93. Okay, but today's date is 15th November, not August. So till 15th August 1993 he will complete how many years? Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 complete years. And after August, till we are, which month is given here? November. That means August, then September, October, November, 3 months. Exactly, date is exactly 15. Okay, so after 15th August, 15 September, 15 October, 15 November means 3 months. So today's age is 5 complete years, that is 5 years 3 months. Okay, 5 years 3 months. Understood? Now pause this video and write this in your note. 24. Example number 24. How many days are there from 15th January 1988. I think these questions are created in 1988. 15th January 1988 to 31st January 1989, next year, how many days are there from 15th January 1988 to 31st January 1989? Okay, so suppose 15th January 1988, you know 1 year has how many days? 365 or 366. See here, normal year has 365 days and leap year has 366 days. Now see, this is which year? 1988. Is it divisible by 4? 1988, is it divisible by 4? If it is divisible by 4, then it is leap year. 4, 4 is 16. See, 28 means 4, 7 is 28. It is divisible by 7. Remainder is getting 0, that means it is divisible. Okay? Or else we can use divisibility test also here. So since 1988 is divisible by 4, that means it is leap year. Okay? So now if we count days, 15th January 1988 to 14th January 1989, 15th January to 14th January, 15th January 1988 to 14th January 1989, 1 year will complete, 1 year, understood? Why for, from, they have asked from 1st, 15th January, so 15th January will be considered as a first day of the year. So the year will end on 14th January of the next year. Okay? So in this year, how many days will be there? If this would be normal year, then there would be 365 days. But this 1988, it is leap year. Okay? And February month is there after January. So there will be 366 days. Means till 14th January, till 14th January 1989, there will be 366 days. But here they have given date 31st January 1989. So after 14 till 31st, how many days? So 15, after 14 January, 15 January to 31 January 1989. How many days will be there? How many days will be there? After 14 until 30, 16 days and this 31, 17 days will be there. You can count 17 days. So total days, this 366 days in one whole year and 17 days till 31st. From 15 January to 31 January, 17 days. So let's add these days together. 6 plus 7, 31 will be carried. 6 plus 7 and 1, 8. And this 3, 383 days will be there. How many? 383 days will be there from 15th January 1988 to 31st January 1989. Whenever this, like this duration is given and asked to find days. See the first day, 15th January, it is the first day of the year considered, okay. The next year will end up on 14th January 1989, okay. Year 1988, 1989. 14th January, one day before. Understood? So these days will be, if it is normal year, then there will be 365 days, and this is leap year, so there are 366 days. Understood? Then now this was up till 14th January. We have to find till 31st January, so we do 15th January to 31st January, 17 days. Okay? So total 383 days. Understood? Next, 25th one. 124 sheets of paper are required to prepare one copy of a book. 124 sheets of paper are required to prepare one copy of a book. To prepare one copy. One copy means one book. How many sheets are required? 124 sheets. Okay? Then, if the size of the book is half the size of the sheets, if the size of the book is half the size of the sheets, how many pages does the book contain? Means in this book, how many pages will be there? How many sheets are required? 124 sheets. Yes, that is Hindi Mam has shown you. Sheet means what? Sheet of paper means? Hindi Mam has shown you. For example, I'll show you again. 1 minute. See, this is one sheet of paper, means this and this. Okay, together it is. This is one sheet of paper. And from this one sheet, how many pages of one notebooks are prepared or made? Four pages. One, then two, three and four. One sheet of paper means four pages of book or notebook. Understood? Since one sheet of paper means how many pages of book or notebook? Four pages of book. Understood this concept? This is one sheet of paper, and from this one sheet of paper, whenever books or notebooks are prepared using the sheet is stitched exactly middle here. Yes, it is folded in this way so that one sheet of paper makes four pages. Okay, so here 124 sheets are there. So each sheet will make how many pages? Four pages. Okay, so total pages of book will be 124 multiplied by 4, that is 4 4s are 16, 1 carry, 4 2s are 8 and 1 9, 4 1s are 4, 4 96 pages. Means that book will have, that one copy of book will have 496 pages. Understood? 496 pages. 124 sheets, that means multiply by 4 pages, that is 496 pages. Understood? So here our exercise 13 is completed. If you have any doubt in this exercise 13, ask me, okay?